Today we're going to be meeting Tanya O’Brian, and she's the Director of Data and Information Management in the Department of Industry, Environment and Planning. Tanya's been leading a very important project in preparing the industry for the next stage of rebuilding confidence in New South Wales. She and her team have been responsible for building the ePlanning platform. Tanya, would you like to share some of the insights that you have into the work you've been doing?
Absolutely. Thanks for the opportunity to come and talk about ePlanning. We have, over the last couple of years, been transitioning the application process, the planning process, into a digital environment. So for too long, the planning world has been all about paper. It's been about how do you apply for a piece of development. You have to go into the council, you have to develop a series of documentation, and it has been a very analog process for that piece of paper to make its way through the approval process. We actually considered how to make this easier for everyone, and part of that process, we went through an end-to-end process with our customer journey mapping, and we found that a piece of paper that theoretically is printed by the applicant then goes through all of the different pathways of the council, records department, the customer service department, the planning department, all of the referral bodies. That same piece of paper can change hands over 100 times, which means that it's a very analog and it's a very procedural base. Nothing can be done concurrently. So in doing and designing what our ePlanning solution is all about, it's about trying to take advantage of digital environments to mean that we can transition that, to make it faster, to make it accessible for everybody, and go into a digital world. One of the key outcomes that we're also trying to get into is the ability for the New South Wales planning system to have a single set of truth, effectively a single source of truth, which means that we will have data from the application part of the world, all the way through from the very first application that the applicant makes through the assessment process. We'll be able to see what gets approved and how that has changed. It might be that it started as a 12-storey building and comes back to an 8-storey building. We'll be able to see, once that approval is received, it turn into a construction certificate. We'll be able to see it turn into an occupation certificate. And all of the key data elements are captured within our ePlanning and our New South Wales Planning Database. So when we're talking about the New South Wales Planning Database, it is a single source of truth for all of our planning information across what is going to be built in New South Wales. And having that kind of database means that we can project into the future. We can start to see what is in the development pipeline, that we can see these types of developments are happening in these areas. And that makes us better in terms of our decision making for infrastructure, for policy, those kind of things. So it's a really powerful piece of information, really powerful database that we're building. And the beauty of this is that it is being rolled out across New South Wales. To start with, yes, we are focusing on the greater metropolitan areas and the eastern seaboard, those higher density population areas and higher density of development that's happening. And we are focusing on those higher density areas. Into the future, we'd like to, and we will be, rolling this out across New South Wales. That means that we can get this level of confidence and surety across New South Wales.
So Tanya, that consistency across the state is really going to create a lot of consistency for developers and planners and also builders to actually deal with a really common platform of data management. It should really be lowering the cost of doing business in New South Wales, shouldn't it?
It should mean that a developer who is able to do a development in one LGA knows exactly what to expect when they go and do a development in another LGA, because they'll be confronted with or presented with exactly the same sets of data requirements in the same platform, in the same environment. The beauty of it also is that at any time they'll be able to go onto their website or their laptop or whatever and have a look at all of the applications that they've got running or the jobs that they've got running at that point, and at the touch of a button be able to see where it's up to.
So this is clearly the opposite of red tape, isn't it?
It is the opposite of red tape. It's all about trying to streamline it, make it easy for everyone, and get us all to a place that we can actually use and extrapolate on that information, which is just so important for making New South Wales the best it can be.
Tanya, as we've worked through this over the last 6 months, because I've only been around for that amount of time, but what I've noticed now is that there's a real commitment to work across agencies as well as just simply work within your agency. Do you want to just talk about some of the excitement that we're finding in that space?
Yeah, absolutely. Our environment is, our work is very much done in a consultative way. We try very hard to make sure that what we deliver is going to add benefit for everyone that's going to be an end user. So we spend a lot of time talking to people about what they need and how they would need to work and improve the way that they work. And what we've found through this process is that there is such a huge appetite for making things better. No one wants to keep doing it the way that we are. Everyone wants to be supported by a system that will make it more flexible, more easy, etc. The system we're going to deliver will introduce a much greater level of standardisation and predictability for everyone, like you were saying earlier. Makes it more efficient and more cost effective for everyone. The system's also picking up on that 24/7 nature of and flexibility that we're all looking for in our workplace now. That means that people are able to extend their work days, are able to be much more flexible, and are able to have a full-time view of what is the most important thing in their life often, which is that development application that they've got going through the system. And that piece of overview, the ability for someone, instead of having to pick up the phone and call the council or call the certifier and wait for a response, it means that they've got that instant level of understanding of what's going on and what's holding up an application in if it is being held up.
The timing's pretty amazing when you think about it, because we're just coming out of a post-COVID lockdown period, and it's never been more important to accelerate new projects into the marketplace. And of course, now we have a new way of working. Potentially 40% of people will spend most of their time out of the office going forward. This is just going to sing at the right time, isn't it?
Absolutely, absolutely. Into the future, we will not need to be, you know, getting into the car and going to the front counter of a council or a building or physically moving ourselves anywhere. We will be able to completely work from our own home office or remotely as much as we need to. This kind of technology is really enabling us to be much more efficient.